Good morning all. Today I am going to discuss the topic rectifier. So before getting to the complete details of rectifier, so I want to discuss two signal parameters. I want to discuss what is AC signal and what is DC signal. So before getting to the rectifiers, I want to discuss what is AC and what is DC. We all know that if anyone, I want you to explain what is AC signal, it simply draw like this. If I want to ask you what is DC signal, you draw like this. So this is the AC signal and this is the DC signal. So I am going to discuss the properties of these two signals. If we have two properties of these two signals, one is based on the direction we classify, and the second one is based on the voltage variation. So these two parameters I am going to discuss of these two signals. So one is direction and the second one is amplitude or voltage variation. If you see the AC signal, the values for AC signal with respect to this x-axis, it consists positive values and the negative values. It consists both positive values and negative values. As it has both positive values and negative values, I am saying that it is a bidirectional signal. It is a bidirectional signal. And if you see, it is x-axis for DC signal. It is x-axis for DC signal. The values for this DC in the negative is no, but in the positive we have. Of course, this is also a DC signal. With respect to this, this is also a DC signal. It is x-axis and it is y-axis, and it is x, it is y. So, actually, we mentioned in the x-axis time and the y-axis voltage. With respect to time, with respect to voltage, we indicate the signals. So what I am going to tell you is, for DC signal, the values of the DC signal will be in positive side or will be in negative side. So in only one of the direction only DC signal consists values. So that's why I am saying DC signal as unidirectional signal. The first point is over. So first point is AC signal is a bidirectional signal and the DC signal is a unidirectional signal. And the second point is I want to discuss whether the voltage is constant or varying. If you see the AC signal, the voltage levels are not constant. Throughout the time period, the voltage values are changing. If you see the voltage at this point, this is the voltage. At this point, this is the maximum voltage. At this point, this is zero. That means the voltage of the signal is not constant. It is varying with respect to the time period. Now, whereas this DC signal, it is for infinite time, the voltage is fixed and it is constant. So, the second point is, for the AC signal, voltage will vary. For DC signal, voltage is constant. So, I have mentioned you the two parameters. So, whether it is bidirectional or unidirectional, whether it is varying or not varying. AC signal is a bidirectional signal and DC is a unidirectional signal. Whereas, this AC signal, AC signal voltage is varying and the DC signal voltage is constant. So, just keep in mind. So, I want to tell you, what kind of signal is this? What kind of signal is this? I want to ask you a question. What kind of signal is this? So, we know that it is in the negative direction or in the negative part, we don't know any values. We can blindly say that it is DC. We can simply say that it is DC because it is unidirectional. It has the values only in one direction, but it has not any values in the other direction. That's why it is DC signal. But we have another property of DC is the amplitude of the DC signal should be constant. But here the values of this kind of signal is varying. So how can we call this kind of signals as? These are pulsating DCs. Pulsating DC signal. That means, of course it is DC, but not pure DC. Still, some amount of AC is present. So this kind of signals are called pulsating DC. That means it is not pure DC. So coming to the point, our topic, that is rectifier. So rectifier is a device which converts AC signal into pulsating DC. So why we go for rectification? Why we need rectification? So where do we need rectifications mean? If you take any electronic circuit, TV or laptop or any kind of electronic equipment present in our home appliances, so that needs DC only. Of course, you are connecting socket to the AC, but internally in the TV, in the laptop, we have a converter, that is AC to DC converter. So most of the electronic equipments need a less DC. So in order to provide DC signal to that kind of appliances, we design this rectifier. So again, how can we design this rectifier? So rectifier is fine. It is AC to DC signal converter. So we use for some kind of home appliances or some kind of wherever DC is needed, we can use that rectifier. That is fine. My question is, how can we design? So we know that we have seen the characteristics of a semiconductor component diode. It is a diode, it is an anode, and it is a cathode. We know that diode conducts in one direction and it doesn't conduct in opposite direction. That means it allows current in one direction, it doesn't allow in opposite direction. We know that AC is a bidirectional signal and DC is a unidirectional signal. If I give AC signal to this diode, so this AC of bidirectional of AC will be converted into uni because it is conducting in one direction and doesn't conduct in other direction. So that's why we can say that this diode can be used as rectifier because it doesn't allow current in one direction and it allows current in only one direction. Based on this property of my semiconductor p-n junction diode, I can use this diode as rectifier. So the basic component or main component present in rectifier is the diode. So we have so many classifications of a rectifier. So if we take the single phase or polyphase, we have so many classifications. But the two important classifications of rectifier are this: half wave rectifier and a full wave rectifier. These are the two kinds of rectifiers. Again, full wave is classified into two. That is center tapped full wave rectifier and a bridge full wave rectifier. These are the two classifications of rectifiers. So step by step, we will discuss in detail about this half-wave rectifier and full-wave rectifier. First, I am going to discuss the operation of half-wave rectifier. So my rectifier is which converts AC into DC. But I never give direct 230 volts to my diode because my diode doesn't handle that amount of AC signal. So before giving large AC signal to the diode, I use in between my large AC and the diode one transformer. Here especially I use step down transformer. So why I am using step down transformer means, so in order to convert AC into DC, as we are requiring very low DC voltages. So I don't want any large DC voltage, I want a few DC voltages. So before converting, I am reducing using transformer. Especially I am using step down transformer. It is a transformer. It is a primary winding. I am indicating less secondary windings. That means it is a step down transformer. It has, I am giving 230 volts, 50 Hz signal here. So based on the type of transformer, this 230 volts will be converted into 6 volts or 9 volts or 12 volts type of the transformer. Based on the type of the transformer, we can get these outputs at the output of transformer. So of course, here I have a large signal AC. Here I have also AC signal, but compared to this, the amplitude is reduced. Some amount of voltage is reduced by using this transformer. Transformer is never changing the property of the signal, but it is not changing the shape of the signal. It is just reducing the voltage of the particular signal. It is still AC. So this AC I am giving to my rectifier circuit. So in half way rectifier, I use only single diode. I am using the one resistor as a load to collect the output. Here I take the output. Here I take the output. So this is a diode, and it is an anode, and it is a cathode. It is a load resistor. So I am going to explain the operation of this rectifier by splitting into two categories. So how my circuit is acting for positive off cycle and how my circuit is acting for negative off cycle. So first I am taking, but it is a 230 volt signal, 230 volts AC signal. So I am going to analyze the circuit operation for positive off cycle now. If I got the positive off cycle of the input signal here, what is the circuit behavior? So here positive off cycle means it is positive and it is negative. It is positive, it is negative. Here anode means positive, cathode means negative. We know that the positive of the anode is connected to positive of the input. That means diode is in forward bias. If the input positive voltage is connected to anode of the diode, that means this diode is in forward bias. So we know that when the diode is in forward bias, it conducts, it allows flow of current. I can simply replace my diode with a closed switch. When the positive off cycle of the input signal is applied to my circuit, my diode is acting as a closed switch. That means freely the current will flow in the circuit. Freely the current will flow in the circuit. Whenever the current is flowing, we know that here the sum amount of current is flowing. We know that V is equal to IR. My output voltage is equal to current into corresponding resistance. As some current is flowing, I get the voltage. So this current is again dependent on the input signal. So if there is any changes in the input, the corresponding changes will be present in the output current. If there are any changes in the output current, the changes will be applicable in the output. So simply, whatever the input signal is there will exactly present at the output when the diode is in closed. So for the positive off cycle of the input signal, diode is acting like a closed switch. As it is in forward bias, we can replace it as a closed switch. The current is flowing. As the current is flowing, I get the corresponding output voltage. Simply I can say that whatever the input is present, with a less amount of drop will be available at the output. This is the operation for the positive off cycle. Now we will see the operation for negative off cycle. So it is a diode. Now I am assuming that I am applying a negative off cycle here. Negative off cycle means it is negative and it is positive. So anode of the diode is connected to negative. Here anode of the diode is connected to negative. That means diode is in reverse bias. We know that diode anode is connected to positive, that means forward bias. Diode anode is connected to negative, that means reverse bias. When the diode is in reverse bias, that means that the diode is not conducting. That means that is not allowing current through. So simply we can replace it with open switch. Simply we can replace the diode with open switch. Here the diode is doesn't conduct. That means whatever the input signal or input current is not passing to output. That means my output current is zero here. My output current is zero. So we know that V is equal to IR. When current is zero, V is also zero. That means in the for the negative half cycle of the input signal, I am getting the zero voltage. So I am going to draw the complete waveform for my half-wave rectifier. So this is the input signal. This is the input signal. T and V in, and I am going to draw the V out. So this is the positive half cycle. This is the negative half cycle. Again, this is positive half cycle. Again, this is negative half cycle. So for positive half cycle, diode on, D on, right? D is the on condition. So that's why we are getting the same signal. For negative half cycle, here D in off condition. Off means reverse bias. So again, this will repeat for other cycles on. D on and D off. So if you clearly see the waveforms, input is a bidirectional signal, whereas my output is a unidirectional signal. Bidirectional signal is converted into unidirectional signal. That means my AC signal is converted into pulsating DC. Okay, thank you.